Like, comment, share and subscribe.
Hawaii's most active volcano continues to spew lava this week, erupting again to cause havoc in Puna. Kilauea has been erupting for nearly a month, displacing more than 10,000 locals. Where is the lava now? Hawaii volcano Kilauea has erupted again this week, spewing fresh lava out into the surrounding Puna region. The volcano erupted again along the lower east rift zone, forcing more lava out into fissures number 8 and 21. Many of the fissures had been inactive for the last 2 weeks, but recent activity has spewed more lava and toxic gas into the Leilani districts. The lava rivers have now destroyed more than 81 properties, including 51 homes. Where is the lava now? The volcano first erupted on April 30 after more than 250 earthquakes hit within a 24-hour period, destroying much of the volcano's crater floor. Since then, more than 23 fissures have opened up in the southern region of Puna, spewing toxic gases and lava into the surrounding residential areas and farmland. The Leilani districts were evacuated early on after 5 fissures burst through the ground and hurled lava towards houses. Since then, the lava has destroyed at least 81 structures as it creeps closer to the ocean. 51 of those structures are homes. The lava flow has snaked its way down to the south coast, reacting with the Pacific Ocean and mixing the atmosphere with deadly hydrochloric acid. The lava has breached the ocean in at least 2 locations, causing new problems to locals in the region. The acreage covered by lava as of Friday night in Hawaii was 2,232 acres, officials said. The Civil Defense Agency also noted that 37 homes are isolated either due to lava surrounding them or roads being cut off by the flow. Earthquakes continue to plague the region, dislodging large parts of the mountain structure and sending lava oozing out into the local farmland. The lava flow is so large it can even be seen from space. Photos taken by the European Space Agency show large, orange lava rivers snaking their way to the south coast. More than 2,000 people were forced to leave their homes to escape the rampaging lava, seeking shelter in nearby Salvation Army shelters. Earthquakes in the area are occurring more frequently, with the quakes striking harder. A 4.1 magnitude earthquake at 5.39 MHST struck the Kauai Fault Zone today, spewing more lava out of the fissures. In an interview with DW, a German news website, seismologist Jessica Johnson said, "The fact that there are still small earthquakes happening, and that there are still ground deformations, tells us that there's still magma being supplied to the lower east rift zone. So we don't expect this eruption to finish anytime soon. The other thing that we do is we look for past patterns to see if we can see similarities as to what the volcano might do next. So the past eruptions have happened in the Puna area. One of them lasted several weeks. The other one lasted a couple of months. So it's definitely not an exact science. While lava stretches out to the south, a separate flow from one fissure continues to advance on the Puna Geothermal Venture Power Facility, which produces 38 megawatts of electricity for the island. Fears that the lava could speed into one of the many underground chambers that generate electricity for the locals had been cleared after the lava failed to reach the area. USGS scientists remain unsure when volcanic activity will cease at Kilauea.